Well, it's not a shortage of stock, but of staff that is crippling retailers as COVID cases explode, sending more workers into isolation across the country. And while rules are easing for those in critical food areas, there's a call for them to be given free priority access to rapid tests and for the hospitality sector to get a look in too.
It's like we're back at the start of the pandemic. Everything picked but sweet potato by nine this morning. Only this time it's staffing, not stock. That's the issue.
I wish we had a crystal ball. You know, I think as long as we see high transmissions in the community, we'll continue to see challenges with our supply chain to varying degrees as the numbers ebb and flow.
Over 20% of Woolworths' distribution team is down, and over 10% of store staff, a problem plaguing other major retailers too. In New South Wales and Queensland, critical food workers are being let out of isolation if they're a close contact and test negative, with similar exemptions to take effect in Victoria later this week. Only they'll all still have to find and take rapid tests.
There's a real need for free rapid antigen tests to underpin a safe return to work for workers in these essential frontline industries.
It's important that workers have quick access and can get those results through to their employer as quickly as possible.
It's an industry call for free priority access to tests that's yet to win over the New South Wales Premier.
Right now, where the government is focused on is ensuring that the rapid antigen tests that we've procured go to those essential services from a state government level, schools, social housing, protecting vulnerable communities.
Hard hit throughout the pandemic and now struggling with staff shortages, the hospitality sector is calling on the government to apply exemptions to its workers as well, or offer financial support.
There are many sources now saying that the hospitality industry is down as much as on average 40% from 2020 and 2019. And they're desperate for that stimulus.
It's better to have the issue of labour shortages than be closed.
That is, though, what a lot of hospitality venues are, an issue New South Wales's Deputy Premier's acknowledged as he himself isolates with COVID.
There's no doubt that, you know, whether it be the hospitality industry, you know, we've done it for food and manufacturing sector. I think it is something that we'll have to look at for the hospitality industry. We know that they've done it tough. They've done it tough for a number of years.
And how long this phase will last isn't clear. Alice Hogg for 10 News First.
Well, let's bring in Ursula Hager now. And, Urs, how are we comparing with the rest of the world?
Well, not well, Hugh. Looking at the cases per population, we have many more than some of bigger countries that have lower vaccination rates. Our World in Data has an interesting comparison showing of cases per million people, Australia now has more relative to population than the United States and the United Kingdom. Of the developed nations, there are still more in Ireland, France, Greece, Iceland, Greenland and Denmark. Taking a look at the data for New South Wales, you can see how it got away from us. To the week to Christmas, the data shows there was a 74% increase in the number of mystery cases, those with no clear source, 3,798, and a further 23,000 under investigation. A reminder, around this time, we did not have compulsory QR check-ins, and for most of it, masks weren't mandatory inside. The delays in testing were also clear. Only 25% of cases were being notified to New South Wales Health by the laboratories within 24 hours. The other issue, Delta, was still spreading across the state. For the month to Christmas, of the 54,000 cases, 4,030 were either suspected or confirmed to have Omicron, while 2,540 were Delta cases. The rest weren't sequenced. Of the 754 in hospital, 33 of those were suspected or confirmed to have Omicron, 101 had the Delta variant. The rest weren't tested, but it still shows that the Delta strain was having, at that point, a greater impact on the hospital system. Now, one last interesting thing to note. We've been told the first case of Omicron in Australia was detected on November the 27th, but New South Wales Health has now confirmed that genome sequencing of older cases has since picked up one the week before. So, Hugh, it is likely that this variant was spreading a lot earlier than we thought.